Andrew Shaw for Marian Hossa. Brandon Saad in control. Back to the point. Seabrook will settle it down. 4 seconds from the power play. Letty's shot negated by Belmore. A loose puck, though. Chicago's on it. Chubble. They score! Marian Hossa picks up the loose change and goes top shelf on his backhand. And Chicago has a 2-0 lead.
A player that's had to earn his way to the NHL, Andrew Shaw. You can see why he's become such a fan favorite in Chicago. Watch right here. What a play he makes. That puck, after Belmore blocks it, is headed out of the Carolina zone. He legally creates the turnover.
Back goes Nick Hjalmarsson. He turned it over. Jackman steps in, but Hjalmarsson jammed up that rush out there to catch the Blues and a change. Hossa's in alone, shooting, he scores! A terrible change by the St. Louis Blues, and Marian Hossa walked all alone from the blue line in. Goals in back-to-back games, and it's 2-1 Chicago.
Pat, we always talk a lot about it. The second period, the long change. The Blues are going to think about going for a change. They don't get the puck in deep. The turnover, and next thing you know, it's a 2-on-0. Hossa and Sharp and Big Hoss decide, you know what? I'm going to let a half slapper go right.
Eddie Purcell had it escape him, and Marian Hossa comes out. Wants Taves into the zone, pulls up. The trailer is Sharp, a long wrist shot, and it's goal! It might have been tipped by Hossa. He got right to the front of the net. Ben Bishop was reaching for it. He's claiming he was interfered with. That is going to be a good goal, it would appear. And I think this game is tied.
Well, the officials are coming together, Pat. We'll have to take a look. There's the shot. Marian Hossa standing right in front of the net. Look at Hossa. Goes in front and stops. It looked clearly to me from that angle that Marian Hossa's stick is in the midsection of Ben Bishop. And I know he's a tall guy. His stick, if he's going to make contact, must...
All right, it's been a video review, and Don Van Massanova just told the crowd they're going to check it about whether the stick was above crossbar level. That's what defines a high stick.
It looked like there, Pat, to me, is that the stick of Marian Hossa was well below the crossbar height of Ben Bishop.
Remember when the high stick was defined by your shoulder length?
Yes.
Your shoulder height, I mean. If you could almost never have a high stick with Ben Bishop then.
Or is there Chara? Or
yeah, right, like that, yeah. Right? But anyway, they're looking up over this in Toronto to try to capture as many angles as they can, and I think that that discussion's already over. Referee has the headset off, and Dean Morton's going to tell us what the decision is.
After video review, the ruling on the ice stands. It's a good goal.
Hjalmarsson rolled at three. Here's Taves chasing it down. 2-on-1 with Hossa. Taves for Hossa right in. He scores! Jonathan Taves set up Marian Hossa. Bang! Right after the Senators take the lead, the Hawks tie him. The 100th goal as a member of the Blackhawks for a two-time Stanley Cup winner. And this game tied at two.
Pat, this is where they take advantage of Erik Karlsson. He hangs in this area here, but this puck is going to get in behind. The eventual goal scorer is going to work himself into this area. Karlsson takes a chance. Puck bounces over stick, and now it's a two-on-one. Taves, what a reception, and right between the wickets of Craig Anderson, and I love the reaction of Big Hoss.
Here's Kane now. Kane hangs. Going to exchange with Hossa, give it to him, the driving goal! The Hawks change positions, and Marian Hossa hammered it home. The power play goal ties it.
Now there's a couple of happy humans, whether they got ice cream on their hands or their face or Now watch the movement here. Here, coming to this area here. And as the first penalty was expiring, Kane to Hossa, short side. And a huge power play goal for the Hawks. And it was 5-on-4. But the movement by Kane caused a little bit of confusion, caused a little bit of opening.
Tender age when he traded a Wayne Gretzky card for a Felix the Cat Potvin card.
Mm-hmm. Why wouldn't he?
Oh, Dave Severs, Hossa scores! Fourth thing is he doesn't like that, and it's 1-1.
Well, he's the guy who dominated the Stars in the season series last year. Taves, it all starts with him, off face-offs especially. They get rotating. I think Hossa ended up the second star in each of the games against Dallas last year. You know, they had coverage, but it stare at the puck coverage. Dylan, instead of going stick on puck, has his stick up in the air. Sweet little pass in tight that probably shouldn't get through, and Hossa barreling down the back door.
Jason takes a tumble. Both Hawks and Stars fans getting into it vocally, and Hossa has a breakaway. He's in, he shoots, he scores.
Well, this just comes down to puck battles, and their top dogs, their elite, their high threat count guys dug in. Puck comes up along the boards. Sharp wins this battle along the boards, wins that battle to nudge it through. An aggressive play by Dylan. He can't keep it in front of him. Three guys go to the puck. Hossa goes to the free ice. And as he wafts in, he becomes the latest elite Hawk to cash in against Kari Lehtinen. Short side. They had them all bottled.
5 minutes gone by here in the second. Hossa moves in. A shot. Oh, up high. Hits fifth. Rebound. He scores! Marian Hossa followed his initial shot and scored on the rebound. The new daddy welcomes his daughter, Zoya, to the world with a goal 2 days later. And it's 3-2. This first shot stunned Mike Smith. I mean, it hit him up high. I think it might have hit him in the mask. But then the follow-up, the quick rebound. He beats Keith Yandle to the middle of the ice. Yandle takes a turnaround. Look where his stick is. He doesn't get it down quick enough. And Big Hoss, with his stick on the ice, beats Mike Smith. High, hard shot. Follow-up. You want to score goals? Get to the front of the net. And Hossa, great patience there, Pat.
Seabrook takes it away for Jonathan Taves. Taves to the front of the net. Score! Marian Hossa finds Jonathan Taves. And again, the Hawks regain the lead. It is 4-3.
This is just skill and execution, plain and simple. Jonathan Taves takes the puck in the middle, and you have to look away from the puck. Frolik sees Hossa, but he can't quite get to him. Ellerby's guarding the front of the net, but he's not turning around and looking at Hossa. And look at the sauce across there.
Ekman Larson. Seabrook will intercept for Taves. Flips it back into the empty net. And Marian Hossa has iced it here tonight in Glendale.
And the Wild have sticks and bodies right on it.
Letty to Versteeg. Hossa in and scores.
These last two goals by the Chicago Blackhawks, really a display of some amazing shooting ability, because these are picking corners. I mean, the both pucks by Saad and now Hossa in and out of the net very quickly, which means it's catching the twine right in the tight part of the net by the post. And check out this shot. Hossa, and this time it's from the opposite faceoff dot. But to score from here is just simply amazing. To have that kind of angle, a goaltender appears very big when he's on the corner crease. And in both the last two shots, parting. Look at him. He's about 2 feet out off his corner crease. I mean, to make that shot is just a pinprick. I'm telling you. What a shot by Hossa. Saad was very...
Heath ahead for Taves. A good pass. Fine. Sharp got a two-on-one. Sharp drives the goal. He shoots it. And a save. Clemens and rebound. He scores! Hossa! He's able to pick up the rebound off Clemenson. The Hawks scored 70 seconds into the first period. They scored 37 seconds into the second.
Pat, this all starts back here. As Antti Raanta comes back, Duncan Keith gives him an outlet. This starts right behind the net. Raanta to Keith. Watch this pass to Jonathan Toews. Right there. Two on one. Patrick Sharp. He's got one thing on his mind, and that's shooting the puck, and then Big Hoss.
Rush didn't work out for L.A. Toews battles it the other. Put it in front. Hossa scores! Jonathan Toews, a Marian Hossa shorthanded goal. And the first time the Kings have given up a goal in the first period in a month and a half. It's 1-0.
Boy, what an effort from Jonathan Toews. From our Honda replay, he lifts up the stick of Jake Muzzin. It was almost one of those, Pat, where he, Toews, that is, let Muzzin go and get the puck. And he lifted up his stick, found it. All in one motion, Hossa beats the LA Kings back to the front.
I wonder what the number would be of opposing forwards that have tried to score on Marty Brodeur. Here's Hossa trying to do it. He did! Marian Hossa snapped it over the glove of Marty Brodeur. It's 4-1. Four goals in the first 5.5 minutes of period three.
Boy, not a good change at all by the New Jersey Devils. And the quick transition, right part of your screen. There's the bad change. Toews to Marian Hossa. Sharp goes to the net. And Marian Hossa goes top shelf as a sliding Bryce Salvador.
He'll play it and leave it right there for Toews. Tries to get loose, delivers the pass, and got the shot. He's onside, dumped it ahead. Toews scores! You can't stop this trio when you let him go like that. Toews sets it up, the game is tied. Sharp was up on the play. Great play by Chicago, top line.
Well, we got one going here now. It comes off a good face-off by Montreal. Again, they've been solid all night. PK gets this through to the net. It's a good rebound for Plekanec, and Corey Crawford's right there to stop it, and like they do so well, Chicago transitions the puck. Watch the nice little chip passes here. Saucer little pass, hold on to it. Nice little pass in front, and Hossa drives himself right to the puck.
And the clear, what a keep by Keith. That allows the 5-on-3 to get set up. Toews to the front of the net. Kane looks back to Hossa. Hossa's one-timer. He scores! A bullet! A birthday bullet for 35-year-old Marian Hossa! And on the two-man advantage, the Hawks back in front.
Pat, the opportunity for the Edmonton Oilers to get the puck out, but again, watch the play by Duncan Keith to keep this play alive. He finds a way to keep it alive on the backhand. And now the rest is history. He puts this on a tee to Big Hoss, and he goes top shelf on Devan Dubnyk. No chance for the goaltender.
Jalmerson, what a pass, and he's able to spring Toews. Jonathan Toews for Hossa, shorthanded into the zone, to the middle, shooting, scored! That all started with a spectacular pass from deep in the Hawks zone. Short-handed with a Hossa tally. 1-0.
Every player for the Hawks touches the puck. Quick pass, but Pat, you picked it up. Watch this unbelievable pass under pressure by Nicholas Jalmerson. Right there. I mean, there's a huge trust factor there. You know that there's going to be somebody there. And then Marian Hossa, quick little move,
hold, shoot, killer down, and now it jumped away from gets that cleared ahead to Hossa. Hossa for the empty net. Hawks win. Marian Hossa gets his second goal of the game, and the Hawks will end the brilliant 18-1 run of the Anaheim Ducks.
Nice steal there by Krejci. Delays, feeds on for Chara, moving in, and a shot didn't get through because of Jalmerson. Sent back out, and a race is on. It's Sharp with it. He's got Hossa in front. Fed it to him.
Well, it looked like the Bruins were going to have a great quality chance here. But watch what ends up happening. Zdeno Chara is not able to get a shot because of the great stick right there by Marian Hossa. And then their Hawks are off to the races. Sharp waits, waits, patience. And the guy that lifted up the stick of his fellow countryman and friend is a guy that ended up scoring a goal, Marian Hossa.
Swing and a miss by Smith, but he's right in on it, along with Bickle. Bickle able to beat one that is shuttled down by a couple of Red Wings. And then Oduya beats one in front side of the net. Takes in front, score, Hossa! And the Blackhawks have struck first.
Eddie, Detroit had everybody they wanted on the ice except for the defense tandem of Jonathan Erickson and Nick Cronwall.
Again, the Blackhawks are in the middle of a change. Look at Brian Bickle. He's by himself. He gets in on a forecheck. He wins this battle. I'll take it's a fortunate bounce there. As Johnny Oduya gets his puck to Jonathan Toews. I thought Toews was going to shoot it right away, but he holds on to it and gets it to Marian Hossa. Somehow this puck bounces in or banks in off of Marian Hossa to the front of the net. Now, it looks like he went off his skate. And then does he get a stick on this before it crosses the goal line? Yeah, it looked like on that look there, that was a better look. A look of went off the shin pad.
Asked Joe Colbert this morning about playing Toews, and he said, if you were to draw against Toews, he's so angry, the thrust of the shift is a tough one. He's that competitive. Here he is in front. What a stop there. Rebound scores. Patrick Sharp has tied it. And that was Toews losing a draw and helping create the game-tying goal.
Right there. After Patrick Kane scored, Patrick Sharp's going to get the rebound here of this brilliant stop from Red O'Bara. Kane had his 25th. Sharp's got his 27th. Oh, I thought this might have been a glove pass, but this actually goes off the glove of David Jones. An excellent call by the official. Like him along with Kruger, they could spare minutes for Toews and Hossa. Here they go, shorthanded.
Two on one, Sutton, Hossa! And a great stick save, battle stop. Hedomerson, Hossa, scores! Marian Hossa's got a shorthanded goal, and the game is tied.
The Flames get their seventh shorthanded goal. The Hawks answer with their sixth shorthanded goal. To 2-on-1, nobody's going to catch Saad and Hossa. Excellent stick by Red O'Bara to keep this pass from going to Saad. The puck goes all the way to the blue line. Watch the play here by Vera. Aggressively poked away. And then Hossa takes the rebound. And he won't miss from there. His 22nd of the season.
Best power play in the league. Up against the third best penalty kill. Letty, Seabrook. Brandon Saad across for Stieg, back door, scores, and it's a beauty for Marian Hossa.
Well, that's their second power play group, Chris. What puck movement. They all touch the puck as they get into the zone. David Booth's goaltender interference penalty proves costly. There's no chance for Luongo here. Letty, Seabrook, Saad, cross seam for Stieg, saucer pass, Hossa. Good night. Beautiful puck movement. The Canucks penalty killers just can't catch up to that smooth a puck movement. You see Richardson and Edler commit on the side.
Tried to
gun it in front, and that was blocked, and back come the Hawks. Taves leads Sharp into the zone. The trailer is Hossa, right across the slot, score!
Against this Chicago team, you got to play in straight lines, and if you get caught deep, they will make you pay. All three Anaheim forwards caught, and Chicago on the counterattack. The Ducks are in pretty good position right now. But then all of a sudden, Corey Perry goes over to pressure the puck on the sidewall. It turns.
Now Duncan Keith plays it ahead for Sharp. On the far side with some feet. Hossa gets behind the net.
Patrick Sharp. He waits and sees that Marian Hossa is winding up with speed. Here's Sharp. Now Detroit gets too fixated on Sharp. They don't look at the entire ice surface. Who's the most dangerous man? The fastest man on the ice, even though he doesn't have the puck yet, is always the most dangerous. Marian Hossa was that guy. Patrick Sharp gave it to him right at the right time, and Hossa doesn't miss many chances like that. Nobody can recover defensively for Detroit.
And with the chances both teams have had, we ought to have five goals on the board in total. And there's only one. Here's a chance for Steve. He scores! Through the five, well, might have been tipped. There was traffic in front of the net from Hossa. And the Hawks are in front by two. Turnover by Anton Roussel, Pat, right there, off the pressure from Hossa, the shot pass right to the stick of Marian Hossa. Two things, Versteeg had one thing on his mind, pass this puck, and Marian Hossa, where was his stick? Buried on the ice.
And the Stars, Dillon, fires it off the glass, took a funny hop to Hossa, Hossa's backhand, he scores!
Attacker, and that's about as lucky a bounce as you could get. That puck should have gone off the glass. It did not.
Back to the corner. Odu, you can't get it out. Here's Mathot. Chops the puck ahead, gives it away. Loose in front. Backhand chance for Hossa. Scores! Hossa buries the Ottawa giveaway. It's a one-goal game.
Well, the Ottawa Senators, even veterans, and have been foreign to making turnovers, just like this one by Mark Mathon. This is tough. You've got the puck on your forehand, you go on your backhand, you're trying to sneak a puck through on the weak side of the ice is wide open, so it's a question of making a choice. And the unfortunate part is, it goes to a guy like Hossa who can bury it right away, but this is a little bit of what...
Marian Hossa looking for his first conversion of this season. And Hossa to Brzgalov, fires right to him! The overpower of Brzgalov and the Hawks in front. Looked like Brzgalov knew what Hossa was going to do here, Pat, but just Big Hoss fires this thing right through. Isn't able to absorb that hard shot from Big Hoss, and that's a big-time goal there.
Back at the point, Seabrook lets it fly. That shot is blocked by R.J. Umberger.
Good job by R.J. to get down there. Took that right in the stomach area. He's going off, but that's a good hurt right there, guys.
On the left wing, moving in, a shot and a goal. Hossa puts Chicago up for the first time tonight.
Tell you what, there's not many guys in the National Hockey League that can move the puck like Hossa. And when he got onto the ice and was able to garner that puck, you watch the hands, and again, he has the legs moving. Watch this move, protects the puck, and then goes back the other way. Looks like he may pull it to the backhand, and that freezes the goaltender. What's he do? Goes back to that foreside. Heath Bobrovsky on that low stick side. But what a play right there by Hossa. That's another highlighter for him.
Keith looking toward for Steve. He rolled into the corner. Hanses put it across, Sharp center. Hossa, they score! Sharp to Hossa with a pinpoint feed, and the game is tied with less than a minute left.
so important when you pull your goalie to win the boards, and the Blackhawks win the boards. They get it down behind the net. You mentioned the feed. Just a bang-bang play, sharp out front to 81. Watch Duncan Keith. Gets it to Versteeg, and there's the key play. Hanzus to Sharp to Hossa out front.
Now a steal by Hossa, and away comes Chicago. Hossa's got Shaw with him. Hossa winding it across the line, steps around board. What a move by Marian Hossa. Runs around and scores! Marian Hossa with a spectacular goal for Chicago. Wow.
Well, I guess the Blackhawks came to play today. And Marian Hossa putting on a clinic. Defense leads to offense. Strong stick, picks Hornquist's pocket, and then off the races. Smartly recognizes that he's got a forward over there. Go after Gabriel Bourque. He can't pivot with you. And he certainly does not. Beats Pekka Rinne to the far post. Banks it in off his skate. What a reach and hook by Hossa. You see him roll his wrist over.
Ryan Bickle's in on the left wing side. Bickle with a pass across into Hossa, the shot. Miller the save, the rebound, they score! Hossa to the goal! 1-0 Chicago!
Even Marian Hossa's in the net. He got cleaned out, but it was too late. Hossa's so good on the puck. He gets a shot and then recovers his own rebound, makes some moves to his forehand to get a little bit more room and puts it in the open side of the net. Ryan Miller doesn't get enough support down low in front of him. Hossa has so many talents on the rush. Chicago really pushes the defenders back. Look at the inside position that Hossa got there. He got away from Barrett Jackman and then Jackman just let him go. Everybody else had turned their eyes to the puck and they're back on Marian Hossa, and Backus comes in too late to help the situation as Ryan Miller couldn't control the rebound. A lot of things went wrong there for the St. Louis Blues.
Outside, back to the line. Cross now Letty, quick redirect side, working his way in, back gets it across, they score! Marian Hossa with the goal!
Brendan saw it as absolutely brilliant on this play. His patience with the puck and then the backhand pass to Hossa. Hossa could have counted the two before he put it in. Saw it at the top of your screen. Makes the play into the middle. Freezes all the Minnesota players. They are all going to him expecting a backhand shot. They're trying to shut off that side. He goes back across the grain, puts it right on Hossa's stick, and Hossa points at
him. You are the man there.
Oh, what a play.
45th career